Hello YouTube, welcome to new Epidotus Hint News, the format which summarizes all the hardware, software and IO synthesizer news. The developers are back from their summer vacation and we have a lot of news. So let's start our recap from the past week. On Monday, the Iraq faceplate developer Grayscale announced the release of the dual algorithm oscillator for the Buchla format, based on the Mutable Instruments Braids Digital Oscillator. The complete engine is approved by Mutable Instruments and is in my opinion an interesting new release because the module will bring refreshment to the Buchla systems. We know that the module choice in the Buchla world is far smaller compared to the ReRack format. I am myself a Mutable Instrument Braids user and I'm glad to see this now in this format because with this module musicians have access to many different oscillator types in just one module. Cool new release from Grayscale in my opinion. Also on Monday, it was time to say goodbye to a best-known hardware synthesizer and to welcome a new one. During this year's Moogfest, Moog Music released the subsequent 37CV, the successor of the Sub-37 analog paraphonic synthesizer. On Monday, Moog announced the official release of the subsequent 37CV limited edition and the discontinuation of the Sub-37. Both versions comes now with an improved sound engine and an upgraded keypad for improved playability. On top, the headphone amplifier is now strong enough to drive most demanding headphones. In my opinion, the new subsequent 37 synthesizer is a good further development of the Sub-37, with nice improvements. I'm pretty sure that the new version will attract again new users. What do you think about the new subsequent 37 synthesizer? Is this an option for you or not? On Tuesday, we got some exciting news from Dave Smith Instruments. At DCS NAMM show, the company announced the Prophet Rev2, a further development of the iconic polyphonic Prophet 08 synthesizer. It features two DCOs per voice, Curtis filters, two types of sequencers, digital effects, and more. Now Dave Smith announced that the Rev2 will be available shortly, also as desktop version, with the same specs. Same as the keyboard version, the desktop version comes also in a cheaper 8 voice version and 16 voice version. For a price of $1,299, the new Rev2 in the 8 voice version is the first Dave Smith analog polysynth available for such a low price. In my opinion, it's a nice deal for everyone who is searching an affordable 8 voice polysynth with a high-end and noble sound engine. If I had the money and the choice between a cheaper Behringer DeepMind 12 desktop and the new Rev2 desktop, I would choose for the synth from Dave Smith, because in my opinion it has a better sound engine and offers a cleaner analog sound. As usual, it's a matter of taste which sound you prefer. Which would you prefer, a Rev2 or a Behringer DeepMind 12 desktop? Would be interesting to hear your opinion. Let's go to the software world, where was quite a lot going on last week. Also on Tuesday, Parawave Audio announced a massive free update for their Rapid Synthesizer plugin for PC and Mac. Initially was Rapid a soft synth based on wavetable synthesis and multi-samples. One of the weaknesses of Rapid was the missing support for importing own wavetables and samples. With the new version 1.1, the developer team introduced finally support for importing new wavetables and multi-samples. Another cool feature is that you can resynthesize any kind of audio source now and transform them in a new multi-sample. Third-party sound designers can be also happy with this new update. With this new update, external sound designers can now design sound banks for it and sell them. With a simple import and export function, musicians can now expand their factory library with new sounds. Great new powerful update for the Rapid Synthesizer in my opinion. For a long time, it was quite around the developer of the Sunriser synthesizer for iOS and VST. On Wednesday, Deep Street broke his silence and published Xeon for iOS, a new two-layer analog modeling synthesizer with Audio Unit version 3 support. Xeon features a high-end synth engine with two oscillators, two sub-oscillators, hard sync, different lovely sounding filters, and a very deep modulation matrix. The latter doesn't sound like something special, because every soft synth has a mod matrix nowadays. But Xeon can do much more with the mod matrix than other synths. In this modulation matrix, you can find a massive amount of modulation options, which gives you a big sound design playground. For example, you can modulate the parameters of the envelopes, different layers, and more. To refine the sound in the final, it features also a second page with several good sounding effects, and on the standalone version, you get also a nice sequencer. To get an idea how Zion sounds, please check my sound demo of it. In short, Zion sounds fantastic, offers a lot of sound design possibilities, and is on the same sound level as the Model 15 app from Moog, in my opinion. Don't miss Zion if you search a massive sounding virtual analog synth for iOS. In the recent weeks, there's been some momentum in the world of granular synthesis. Just recently, a free granular synth for Windows came on the market, then the first real hardware granular synth was introduced and came very soon on Kickstarter, and now we are going with a new granular soft synth from Ableton. Dylan Baston released in collaboration with Ableton Iota, a new Max for Life granular looping instrument that allows musicians to import own samples and to transform them in massive granular spheres. The device features a nice and clever designed interface and invites musicians to create instant unheard sounds. In my opinion, a very nice new instrument for Ableton Live users and especially great for experimental musicians. Since I love granular synthesis a lot, I'm happy to see what has recently came out on the market. A relatively surprising release came again in late Wednesday evening. The French company UVI announced last week the release of the Vintage World 2 sample-based synth collection. Compared to the first version, the new one comes with 7 new sample-based products and includes in total 50 instruments, 111 drum machines and over 7000 presets. Besides this big release, the company presents also the OB Legacy, a sample-based product based on the iconic Tom Oberheim instruments Metric 6, Metric 1000, OB6, OB12, OBX, OB1 and more. In the first test, the new OB library convinced me because it comes again with authentic interfaces and contains the typical fat sounds of the Oberheim synthesizers very nicely. It's certainly not a cheap product, the Vintage World 2, but for the amount of high quality instruments and sounds, the price is absolutely fair in my opinion. Unfortunately, UVI doesn't include the amazing Synth Anthology 2 bundle in the Vintage World 2, but I don't understand. Nonetheless, if you search authentic sounds from many vintage synths, then check out this new release. On Thursday, the German developer Tone 2 released a major update 2.5 of their Saurus 2 synthesizer for PC and Mac. Besides sound engine optimizations, the developer adds drags and drops modulation support, which enhances a lot of workflow for sound designers. Also cool is the long overdue MIDI learn support for the knobs. In total, a nice free update for the excellent sounding virtual analog synthesizer Saurus 2. Unfortunately, I'm not a user of the synthesizer myself, so I can't tell you my impression of it. Welcome in September. Clefgrant released on Friday Synthware synthesizer for iOS and as plugin. An interesting new release because the developer tried to include here a new approach to play a synthesizer. Synthware doesn't include a big interface with a lot of knobs, but only an interface with a three-dimensional spheres where musicians can morph through presets to find the perfect sound. In my opinion, a cool new app that it brings a bit of refreshment to the synth app and plugin world, because many of the latest releases were overwhelmed with knobs. Also to mention here, the plugin version is available for free and the iOS app is affordable and available for $199 on the iTunes store. On Sunday, I decided to refresh my list of free PC and Mac synthesizer plugins on my website. I add some new cool different sounding plugins to the list. Please visit synthanatomy.com and go to the free plugin and iOS section. I'm pretty sure you will find a nice free synth plugin for your next music production. For my synth tip of the week, I recommend you the album Several Miles Wide from the German artist Kordenspur. Since I'm a big fan of space ambient music, I like this album very much because it includes typical sequenced synth sounds, nice lead and pad sounds. I didn't know the artist before, and I first learned about it by surfing in the night through some of these space music related artists on Bandcamp. Besides this, I recommend you always to check out the artists on Bandcamp. Here you can find some really excellent indie artists with excellent albums for only some euros. Big thanks for watching this new episode of Synth News. As usual, you can find all the links in the video description just below. And if you enjoyed this video, please leave a positive thumb and a subscription for more future videos. Big thanks for watching and for continued support. I hope to see you again in one of my next videos. Bye!